वेलकम बैक ऑल द क्लास 10 स्टूडेंट्स टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस विद श्रीराम पब्लिक स्कूल. वी हैव बीन ऑन अ वेकेशन सिंस रीसेंट डेज. नाउ वी आर बैक विद आवर रिवीजन टेस्ट. आफ्टर दिस रिवीजन टेस्ट वी आर गोइंग थ्रू द आंसर की ऑफ द रिवीजन टेस्ट बाय अ वीडियो. This video will explain all the answers of the revision test so that you can duly match your answers and thoroughly see where you are lacking. Now, your first question was a letter writing question. As you know, letter writing is the most important thing in your paper. Not only in your paper, in your daily life even, letter writing is very important. If you have to write application for even in school or for any bank or for any purpose, you must be knowing formal letter and its format. That is why it's very important in class 10th level as well as for class 12th level as well. Now, your question was that you are Savita Khanna and you have to write an article as per article of India Today. You have to write a letter to the editor. And the article was on topic banned poly bags. Now, Savita Khanna, 50C, Pushpa Vihar, New Delhi. This is sender's address, after which you have to leave one line. Thereafter, you have to write date. You must have written the date of that day of the exam. Thereafter, you have to leave one line and you have to write the receiver's address. And the receiver's address is the editor, that is the designation, and the firm name, India Today, and the location, that is New Delhi. Thereafter, or Delhi. Subject. Subject is views on the article. You have to express your views on the article, ban poly bags. Now, you have to give salutation, your respected sir or dear sir you may use. Now, this is with regard to a recent article titled ban poly bags. You have given introduction of the topic. Thereafter, now you will present your views. I would like to present a few views in this regard to the recent incessant ban on poly bags all over the city. Now, incessant means unstoppable ban is now getting put. And because of this, there are many problems. It's good for the environment, but is leaving consumers confused, bewildered as what alternative they should use. So they are very much confused. Even most of the restaurants, delivery parcels are delivered in bag that look like cloth, but they are actually non-recyclable material. So, is actually the plastic banned? That's a question. What the writer here wants to say, that it's actually a question whether the plastic has been banned or not. Even if it's banned, you should implement it in a proper way, bringing some proper guidelines and a proper substitute for the plastic, so that consumers may use some better option alternative in place of plastics and this problem might be fixed. Thereafter, the conclusion. Through your magazine, I just want to make the authorities aware that half-baked changes, means half-cooked, not properly cooked, not properly dissolved changes are there. Therefore, there's further disruption and the customers, the consumers are experiencing inconvenience. Thereafter, you have to write a thank you note. Thank you for this opportunity you have provided me, through which I had expressed my thoughts on this matter. And I'm optimistic and positive that my plea, my request will be taken into consideration and it reaches the intended authorities and steps are taken to make banned poly bags a successful exercise. Thereafter, you have to write a complimentary closing. That's yours sincerely. And there's no apostrophe, yes, remember that. And the name of the person, the sender, Savita Khanna. Now, your second question was an exercise on prepositions. Now, this preposition exercise will not come like this in the exam. It will be a paragraph which is interconnected so that it will be a better understanding it will give and you'll be able to attempt it more easily with the options given. The options will also be given. So this is because this was a general test, so general preposition exercise was given to you. Now here you had to fill some preposition in all these 8 sentences. These are the answers of the prepositions. I was amazed ke saath kaun sa preposition do we use? We use at. She is anxious टू रिमेंबर एंशियस टू हियर बिकॉज फ्रॉम टू हियर फ्रॉम हर डॉटर शी वॉन्ट्स टू हियर फ्रॉम हर डॉटर इन द नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस अगेन वी हैव एंशियस बट नाउ शी इज एंशियस अबाउट नोइंग हर डॉटर्स हेल्थ सो हियर वी यूज अबाउट ही अपोलोजाइज्ड टू हर for his rude behavior they appealed again appeal is a request appeal to request to us requested to us for help so here appealed to us for help he appears to be rather opinionated so appears to be he wants the best candidate to be appointed to the post she has an aptitude for maths now After this, there's a literature section which we had, and the questions were very easy. What does the poet compare fire with in the poem Fire and Ice? So fire is compared with desire and ice was compared with hatred. And the poet says the world could end in fire as the poet supported that opinion, but he says if it had to perish twice, ice would also suffice. So this was a poem. Thereafter again we had one more poem in the syllabus as prescribed that was Dust of Snow and here the significance of crow and hemlock tree was that crow and hemlock tree are the symbols of negativity and here they are used by the poet to bring about a positive change in the poet's life how he goes under the hemlock tree how he sits there thinking very sadly in a depressed mood and when this crow sits on this hemlock tree it showers dust of snow which makes the poet's mood lightens it and also saves the part of the day which he might have ruined now next question why was Mrs. Pomfrey worried about Tricky because Tricky was becoming a blotted sausage jame hue maans ke tukde jaisa and he was getting lazy and lazier and according to her he started getting weak but actually what happened to him he became lazy nothing else what was the amount that Lenko wanted from God and why he wanted 100 pesos because his crops were destroyed and now he needed money to feed his family so that is why Lenko was in need of money and he found no other way and he directly went to post office and wrote a letter to God and asked direct help from God as a money order from God himself so this is your answer key the paper was quite easy and I hope the way it's presented the answer key you will go through it thoroughly We will have discussion of the answer key surely in the evening class along with the mark list you will be given. And after that, from next class onwards, we'll be having our regular classes. So be ready for the regular classes also. English is a very interesting subject. So it's my due request also and suggestion also that don't miss your English classes. Even if it's not important from your exam point of view, if you don't think it's important for your daily life. English is a representation. English is a need of time, which is needed the most at this time particularly, where everything is published in English and every person has to understand English. We don't have any other option. This is your answer key. To learn these things is not that you are learning something for exam. You are learning these things for your life. Writing a letter is not just for exam. Yes, it will help you to gain records by scoring well in exam. But along with it, you will develop the habit of writing letters. And even if you have to write an application for your debit card, ATM, change of phone number for bank, or you have to apply for something, visa, passport, or anything, if you had to write application, you don't have to run and go to some person, some cyber cafe or something. And you don't have to take that copy-pasted application. You will have original, your own application, which you can write and send. For these prepositions, you must know what you need to use where. Then only you can frame sentences. And for this literature is life lessons. the poems, the story, everything has moral and theme, which makes you learn something and which is very important for your lifetime. So it's better that you learn these things. These are important, not for exam, but for life. That's all for this session. Thank you. Have a good day.